Hey, what's up? I'm Joey from Doc Dracula, and you're watching Victor V.
I'm currently on the Horror Nights tour. It's with Get Scared, Vampires Everywhere, I Set to Kill, and Aiden. It's an actually really good tour for us because I think we're a little bit different from all the bands, but I think the package in general draws somewhat of a different crowd a little bit, but everybody kind of meets in the middle. It's a fun tour. It's nice, like, you know, to come out to play to new different fans. You know, we've been in the metal circuit for so long. Coming out and kind of breaking out of that for the first time in a long time is really nice, and it's been excellent.
It is amazing to be on the road again, Horror Nights tour. It's been a while since Aiden actually done a U.S. tour headline, so it's like going back and there's all these kids that we haven't seen in so long, and they're just like embracing us with open arms, and it's been so rad. It's like cool to see all these fans that we've had, and they're still there.
It's been so long since we toured, you know, it's been about a year. My voice thrashed, getting beat up, but it's nice to be back out on the road.
The bands on the tour are all awesome. We've been, like I said, hanging out with everybody. I really enjoy watching Get Scared. I think they sound really good every night, and I like their songs a lot. Dr. Acula is super, super heavy. Like, they're really fun to watch. Kind of makes me want to mosh, but I'm kind of a wuss, and I don't want to hurt myself. But they'll definitely rip your face off. They're really entertaining.
Dr. Acula will smash your face. That's all I got to say. No, they're good. They're good kids, yeah. Good guy. I shouldn't say kids, they're older. But good guys. Good band.
So we shot Who You Gonna Call here in Chicago. It was about 2 days of shooting, which was excellent. A couple ideas for the Who You Gonna Call video was, you know, just like thrown around, whether it was gonna be, you know, us just hanging out, more along the lines of like something with Ghostbusters type deal or something. And we finally just came up with the concept of us kind of, you know, going to a party that was lame and kind of busting in and, you know, making it our own.
I had a fucking blast doing the fucking video, man. Like, I don't know. It was mad fun 2 days of just chilling, partying, fucking having a good time.
Futz around with everybody. That's what we did. It wasn't really work. It was a lot of fun. We did what we had to, but we got done and had a blast doing it.
Positive feedback. There's negative feedback. You know what I mean? It's all in good fun. Fuck it.
Yeah, kids take it way too seriously that we're not serious. They don't think we're a real band. We are, though. They need to realize that we're not going anywhere. And videos like that from us probably gonna happen for a while, so they need to suck that up.
It was the most laid back thing. Like, we were not expecting it to be laid back. We were, you know, uptight. Like, schedule was tight, everything went according to schedule, but it was totally enjoyable.
A point of view came through, right? You know, it kind of was supposed to be cheesy, you know, it had like a kind of comedy element to it. And I think it was a cool start for us, you know, and I'd like the other videos to kind of continue on as kind of, you know, part two, part three to that. That's the biggest response we've gotten to the CD. You know, all the bands we met up on this tour, first day, they were like, dude, we love your video. It's so funny. You know, we ran to We Came as Romans recently, and the drummer was like, yeah, we love your video. You know, kids are thinking it's funny, so, you know.
We were sweating our asses off playing in those windbreakers. That's all I gotta say. It was
like, what, 6 hours?
Oh my God, my clothes were soaked. But that's what I can remember.
Yeah,
just
that was
sweating
that
my
the
ass
days
up
of
in
the,
those windbreakers.
EA t-shirts that make my life a lot easier.
And when we were filming the green screen for that car part, that was hilarious. I had no idea what to do. Like, if you actually watch closely, you'll see me like, I don't know what to do. So it was really funny though. It came out awesome.
Remind me of, like, Rob Zombie video.
It's fun. Like, even watching it now, it's like I still watch it and still like get excited watching it. It's been out for like a couple months now, so it's a lot of fun. I love that video.
I think in the grand scheme of all the Aiden records that we've made over the years, I really think Disguises is our heaviest record. I feel like it's heavy, but it's still very catchy, which is something that we've always tried to keep in the mix.
We're always one of those bands that's growing and changing, and, you know, we try new things, and and we've always been a punk band, and we don't give a fuck if someone thinks we should sound a certain way. We're gonna do what the fuck we want to do. We're gonna sound a certain way because we want to write the records that we want to write. And if people are all about it, awesome. If they're not, they didn't get it, who gives a fuck? Because we do what we want to do and we do what we love.
I wrote Knives and I wanted to not make, I wanted it to be as far away from a personal album as you could get, you know? I didn't want to write about myself at all. Characters and stories about things, events that have happened throughout history, Elizabeth Bathory, you know, weird shit like that. I kind of tried to bring it back to a more personal, what's affecting me in my life today, you know, and what kind of shit I think the world is in. I can't remember the exact quote, but Oscar Wilde once wrote that man is least himself if you give him a mask. So I kind of wanted to make a record that had that theme, how people don't really say what they mean, and they don't mean what they feel. A lot of people are just full of shit.
Sweat a lot. Our AC is broken, so that's excellent. So it's smelly, but other than that, it's great. And we all managed to get along, which is something we've struggled with for years as far as lineups go. We all love each other. We've had no problems as far as like the space thing. We don't get a space. We have no space. No personal space is ever available, but we like it. We've become a very tight-knit group. We were never really that way. It was always like kind of a businessy thing, and now we're like the best group of friends we ever could be, which is excellent. It makes the whole touring experience excellent.
What's up? I'm Joey from Dr. Acolyte. I play keyboards. Just got done playing an excellent set here in Chicago, and I'm about to show you our lovely ride of what we live in when we are on the road. All right, this is the lounge right here. We got a nice flat screen, which we watch all of our movies on. We got a built-in DVD player on the side. We got the old school Nintendo 64 down over here with just about every game you could possibly want to play. We have everything from War Gods to Clay Fighters to Kirby, I mean everything. WWF No Mercy, that's where it's at. And yeah, we pretty much just lounge around up here, and we got the two benches. And then if you come on back in here, we got the nice, I like to call it the king size bed here. We usually fit about three comfortably on here. And we got the two guys on the bed here. That's really about it for the interior. I want to take you to our bunk area where the magic usually happens. And then we come to the underground, which is, if you're claustrophobic, you're not going to like it, but pretty much it's dark down here 24/7. You kind of just weasel your way in here and lay down, and you can fit two people under here, and that's it. Pull this down, shut the world out, and just go to sleep. And then that's locked up, and we come this way. I don't know if you want to come this way. We get a shot of the guys. You want to open this up, show them the lounge?
Yeah.
Or you show them your lounge? See, now when you're on the road and you know, you got to make a run to the store or anywhere and you can't take the van and trailer, we like to open this bad boy up right here, just like so. Oh. And we take out this little hog right here. She gets about 30 miles to the gallon. And we blast it all over. I don't know if it's gonna start. I think we ran out of gas last time. But yeah, this is our baby right here. So when we need to make a run to the store or somebody just feels like getting away, we hop on our little bike here and we are history. So yeah, you saw the smoking lounge, you saw our crib, and now it's time for me to go wash this off my face and look beautiful.
Thank you guys so fucking much. I'm a wonderful evening.